Možda ćeš jednoga dana odoleti vremenu koje nas razdvaja i zaustaviti sve u nekom lepenskom oblutku da pripoveda istoriju naših večeri između prvog slova u trouglu kosmičke moći i spiralnog bila naroda koji još traga za korenima.
Dragi gledaoci, dobar dan i dobrodošli u još jednu subotnju emisiju Oslobađanja istorije na kanalu Narodne televizije Snage naroda. Danas mi je posebno zadovoljstvo što mogu u našem studiju da ugostim jednog sjajnog čoveka koji nije prvi put u Beogradu, bio je ovde i pre dve godine i oduševio je sve koji su ga slušali na tribini koja se održavala u amfiteatru Pravnog fakulteta. I to smo ponovili i ove godine, ali da vas ne držim toliko dugo u neizvesnosti, moj gost danas je šejh Imran Nazar Hosein, jedan od najboljih, rekla bih, poznavalaca islamske eskatologije danas u svetu. Čovek koji tumačenjem svojim, specifičnim tumačenjem Kurana, pokušava da objasni događaje koji se dešavaju i čija je knjiga uvod u metodologiju istraživanja Kurana, dakle, upravo objavljena u izdavačkoj kući Pešić i sinovi iz Beograda. I sa nama će danas u gostima biti i gospodin Stefan Karganović, koji je ovu knjigu preveo, a ja ću iskoristiti priliku da se zahvalim i našem saradniku na ovom projektu, gospodinu Fejsalu Abašeru, koji je bio redaktor ovog izdanja, kao i profesor Pravnog fakulteta, dr. Branko Rakić, koji je napisao jedan briljantan predgovor za ovu knjigu. Gospodine Imrane Hoseine, dobar dan i dobrodošli u Srbiju.
Hello, Mr. Imran Hosein. Good day and welcome to Serbia.
Thank you very much.
Hvala vam.
Ja ću početi naš današnji razgovor jednom divnom rečenicom koju sam upamtila, a kojom ste vi takođe počeli vaše izlaganje pre nekoliko dana na Pravnom fakultetu, gde ste održali tribinu u povodu izlaska vaše knjige, a ona glasi: istorija počinje istinom.
I'm going to start by quoting a wonderful sentence that you used in your lecture at the Faculty of Law of the University of Belgrade a couple of days ago, where you had a presentation of this book that we have published, and that sentence was, history begins with the truth.
Šta se dalje dešava?
So what happened after that?
We begin with Allah's blessed name and we praise him and we glorify him as he ought to be praised.
Počinjemo sa blaženim imenom Allaha, hvalimo ga i proslavljamo ga onako kako treba da bude hvaljen i proslavljen.
And we pray for peace and blessings on all his noble messengers.
I mi se molimo za mir i blagoslov na svim njegovim plemenitim poslanicima.
Let me first of all say that I'm happy to be back again in Belgrade.
Pre svega da kažem da sam vrlo radostan što se opet nalazim u Beogradu.
I never thought that I would come back.
Nisam pretpostavljao da ću da se vratim.
But I planned and he planned, he brought me back.
Ali ja planiram i on gore planira i on me je vratio u Beograd.
And I pray that I may be able to come back again one day.
Ja se molim Bogu da ću jednog dana opet moći da dođem.
I'm now 75 years of age and so travel is difficult.
Ja imam 75 godina i putovanje mi teško pada.
But the warmth with which I have been received by the people of Belgrade and the Serbian people that warmth with which I have been received makes it easy for me to come back.
Ali toplina koju su mi iskazali ljudi u Beogradu i u Srbiji garantuje da ću sigurno opet doći.
They have received me with warmth and with love despite 600 years of bloodshed and tears.
Oni su me primili sa toplinom i ljubavlju uprkos 600 godina terora i krvi.
And all of this is because history began with truth.
I sve to je zato što je istorija počela sa istinom.
At the beginning of history there was an announcement by the Lord God.
Na početku istorije Gospod Bog je najavio jednu stvar.
And the announcement was pertaining to political history.
Najava se odnosila na političku istoriju.
In the Quran, the Lord God addressed the angels and said, I'm going to place on earth those who will rule.
U Kuranu Gospod Bog se obratio anđelima i rekao je, ja ću postaviti na zemlji nekoga ko će njom da upravlja.
And they ask, how can you do that when this is going to cause bloodshed?
I oni su ga onda upitali, ali kako možeš to da učiniš kada će to izazvati krvoproliće?
And oppression.
I tlačenje.
And in this part of the world, 600 years of tears.
A to otprilike otpisuje ovaj deo sveta tokom zadnjih 600 godina.
And his reply was,
i Božji odgovor je glasio,
that I know what you don't know.
Ja znam one stvari koje vi ne znate.
That history will end with truth.
Da će se istorija i završiti istinom.
Despite 600 years of bloodshed and tears.
Bez obzira na 600 godina krvoprolića i suza.
And so we have to read the historical process.
I zato mi moramo da čitamo istorijski proces.
From the beginning of history.
Od početka istorije.
To be able to absorb all the pain and suffering of the years.
Da bi mogli da razumemo i upijemo sav bol i svu patnju koji su se odvijali tokom tog dugog perioda.
Confidence in our hearts.
Sa pouzdanjem u srcima.
That history will not end with a clash of civilizations.
Da istorija se neće završiti sukobom civilizacija.
But history will end with the final and conclusive triumph of truth over all rivals.
Nego da će se istorija završiti sa konačnim i odlučnim trijumfom istine nad svim njenim rivalima.
And there are two people who will stand firm on the side of truth.
I postoje dva naroda koji čvrsto stoje iza istine.
In that final and conclusive battle against the forces of falsehood and oppression.
U toj posljednjoj i odlučnoj borbi protiv snaga tlačenja i terora.
And they are your people and my people.
A to su vaš narod i moj narod.
Mi sada mislimo na pravoslavne hrišćane i na muslimanski.
Are we now thinking of narod. Orthodox Christians and Muslims?
The Orthodox Christian world, yeah. And the world of Islam is written in the stars.
Na nebu je zapisano, u zvezdama je zapisano, to se odnosi na svet pravoslavnog hrišćanstva i na svet islama.
And I have come to Belgrade to tell them, look up in the stars.
I ja sam došao u Beograd da im kažem, pogledajte gore, na nebo u zvezde.
Da, iz tog razloga vi vrlo često u vašim obraćanjima kažete da će veoma važan moment u istoriji biti kada pravoslavni svet bude vratio svoju otetu crkvu Aja Sofiju koja se nalazi u Konstantinopolju, današnjem Istanbulu.
So you have been saying, have you not been, that a very important turning point will occur once the Orthodox world receives back its holy place that was violently taken away from it at some point in history, and that is the Cathedral of Hagia Sophia in Constantinople.
Yes, the Cathedral, excuse me, of Hagia Sophia in Constantinople is already beginning to play a strategically important role. Written up in the stars, bringing these two worlds together.
Crkva, Saborni hram Svete Sofije u Konstantinopolju već počinje da igra strateški značajnu ulogu i to je takođe zapisano tamo gore.
Hagia Sophia symbolizes what is to come in the future.
Sveta Sofija je simbol onoga što dolazi u budućnosti.
That the worlds of Islam and Orthodox Christianity will be united in brotherhood and solidarity.
Da će svetovi pravoslavnog hrišćanstva i islama biti ujedinjeni u solidarnosti i prijateljstvu.
Don't look to other things that are peripheral importance.
Nemojte obraćati pažnju na druge stvari koje su od marginalnog značaja.
To understand the future of Islam and Orthodox Christianity relations, look to Hagia Sophia.
Da bi mogli da razumete budućnost odnosa između pravoslavlja i islama, obratite pažnju na Svetu Sofiju.
U tom smislu, vi takođe veliku podršku, zapravo veliki značaj pridajete danas najmnogoljudnijoj zemlji pravoslavnoj hrišćana, a to je Rusija.
In that sense, you have been devoting a great deal of attention in your public statements to the biggest and most populous Orthodox country, which is Russia.
Moje pitanje se odnosi upravo na to kako vi vidite ulogu Rusije danas u svetskim događajima.
So my question is, how do you view the role of Russia today in world events?
I get my guidance from the Quran.
Ja svoje rukovodstvo tražim u Kuranu.
Mm-hmm. Muslims who listen to me must know that.
Muslimani koji me slušaju treba to da razumeju.
And those who are my critics must also remember that I get my guidance from the Quran.
I oni koji me kritikuju takođe treba da uzmu u obzir činjenicu da ja svoje rukovodstvo crpim iz Kurana.
And if my understanding and explanation of the Quran is correct,
ako je moje shvatanje i moje objašnjenje Kurana tačno,
then this will prevail.
Onda će ovo da preovlada.
Regardless of what the critics say.
Bez obzira na to šta kritičari govore.
I have understood the Surah Al-Kahf of the Quran, the Surah of the Cave.
Moje shvatanje sure pećina iz Kurana je
to have prophesied at once that some that in time to come power will emerge in the region of the Black Sea.
U toj suri stoji da će u nekom budućem vremenu vlast u svetu, moć u svetu da izađe, da se manifestuje u predelu Crnog mora.
And anyone would know that if you control Crimea, you control the Black Sea.
I svako zna da ako vi kontrolišete Krim, vi kontrolišete Crno more.
That Crimea symbolizes power in the Black Sea.
Krim je simbol moći u Crnom moru.
That power therefore will emerge in the region of the Black Sea and therefore Crimea.
Moć u tom smislu će se manifestovati u regionu Crnog mora preko Krima.
And that power will rest on the foundations of faith in the one God.
I ta moć će počivati na temeljima vere u jedinoga Boga.
And that power will be used successfully to punish the oppressor.
I ta moć će uspešno biti korišćena da kazni tlačitelja.
Punish those who are committing acts of corruption and destruction on earth.
Da kazni one koji kvare poredak na zemlji i koji ga razaraju.
And today we see that that is precisely what is now occurring before our eyes.
I danas mi vidimo da se upravo to događa pred našim očima.
The return of Russia to its spiritual heart.
Rusija se vraća svom duhovnom srcu, svojoj duhovnoj srži.
And the emergence of Russia as a powerful state.
I manifestacija Rusije kao moćne države.
Resisting the imperial lust.
Koja se suprotstavlja imperialnoj pohlepi.
Who want to impose their barbaric rule on all of mankind.
Koja nastoji, ta imperialna pohlepa, da nametne svoj varvarski sistem celom čovečanstvu.
This is what I see that parallels what is in the Quran.
Ja vidim između toga i onoga što piše u Koranu jasnu paralelu.
And so I have a word to offer to the Russian people.
I zato ja bih ponudio sledeću reč, sledeće izlaganje ruskom narodu.
That you are on the path of truth.
Vi idete putem istine.
And that you are eventually destined to be successful.
I vaša sudbina je da budete uspešni u onome što radite.
Da. Mislim da će se i većina Srba sa vama složiti.
I think that most Serbs will agree with you.
Jer mi danas živimo u veoma teškim vremenima.
We are facing very hard times today.
Suočeni smo sa diktatom koji dolazi iz jednog mračnog totalitarnog uma.
We are facing the dictates that have emerged from a dark totalitarian mindset.
I koji svetu nameće jednu kreaciju na koju svet ne može da pristane.
And which is trying to impose upon the rest of the world a system that the world simply cannot accept.
Da. I ja bih volela da možda kao najbolju ilustraciju ovoga što sam upravo rekla, vi ispričate nešto što sam takođe čula na jednom od vaših predavanja.
And perhaps the best illustration of what I've just said would be if you would recount to us something that you said in one of your lectures.
A to je period kada ste proveli 12 godina u Njujorku.
And that is the 12-year period that you spent living in New York.
I kada je pitanje koje je došlo sa strane tog mračnog totalitarnog uma bilo jedino sagledavanje vaše ličnosti, ono koje se sastojalo u vašoj novčanoj, da kažemo, sposobnosti.
You will of course elaborate, but the way I understood it, according to that dark totalitarian mindset, your entire personality was reduced to your monetary self.
To je pitanje.
That's the question.
When I was in New York, I wanted to rent an apartment.
Kada sam živo u Njorku, želao sam da iznajmim stan.
And you had to then submit your credit history.
I da bi to učinili, vi morate da podnesete svoju takozvanu kreditnu istoriju.
When the owners of the apartment examined my credit history.
I kada su vlasnici tog stana pregledali moju kreditnu istoriju.
They said to me, Mr. Hussein, you do not exist.
Oni su mi rekli, gospodine Hussein, vi ne postojite.
Because I had no credit history.
Zato što nisam imao nikakvu kreditnu istoriju.
The heart of the system.
Suština sistema, srž sistema.
Is a system of oppression to get you entrapped in credit.
To je sistem tlačenja koji stremi da vas uhvati u klopku kredita.
So not only do they control military power.
Ne samo da oni kontrolišu vojnu moć.
Not only they control political power.
Ne samo da kontrolišu političku moć.
But that they control monetary power.
Oni također kontrolišu i finansijsku moć. Power.
Financial.
Finansijsku moć.
At the beginning of history, those who were on the side of truth and of justice.
Na početku istorije oni koji su na strani istine i pravde
were the underdogs.
su bili oni koji su bili slabiji u tom odnosu.
They didn't control power.
Oni nisu kontrolisali moć.
They didn't control government.
Nisu kontrolisali državu.
They didn't control the monetary system.
Nisu kontrolisali novac, finansijski
sistem. They didn't control the economy.
Nisu kontrolisali ekonomiju.
And yet, when the time came and the enemies were there about to destroy them.
I kad je došlo vreme i kad su njihovi neprijatelji mislili da malo fali da ih unište.
And I speak these words to remind my brothers who are Jews.
I ja ove reči izgovaram kao opomena mojoj braći Jevrejima.
That the Lord God said to Moses, take your staff and strike the water.
Gospod Bog je rekao Mojsiju, uzmi tvoj štap i doći će voda.
And those who control power.
I oni koji kontrolišu vlast.
And control the media.
I koji kontrolišu medije.
And control the monetary system.
I kontrolišu finansijski sistem.
They were all drowned.
Oni su se svi podavili.
Today once again we are the underdogs.
Danas mi smo opet oni koji se nalaze u slabijem položaju.
And they control military power.
Oni kontrolišu vojnu moć.
They control political power.
Političku moć.
They control monetary power.
Finansijsku moć.
And with cryptocurrencies they are about to take control and enslave the world.
I sa kriptovalutom oni su na ivici da ugrabe kontrolu nad celim svetom i da ga porobe.
What I say to the two people.
Ali ja kažem dvema narodima
who await the return of Jesus.
Koji čekaju da se vrati Isus.
The world of Islam,
svetu Islama,
and the world of Orthodox
i svetu pravoslavnog hrišćanstva.
That when Jesus comes back,
da kada se Isus bude vratio,
it will be like Moses taking his staff and striking the water.
To će biti kao kada je Mojsije uzeo svoj štap i udario po vodi.
And then the oppressor will bite the dust.
I to će biti konačni kraj tlačitelja.
So I say to the people of Serbia.
I zato ja bih rekao narodu Srbije.
Do not lose heart.
Nemojte biti obeshrabreni.
Do not be in a state of demoralization.
Nemojte biti demoralisani.
Do not give up hope.
Nemojte da se odreknete nade.
But to stay firm with the truth.
Budite čvrsto uz istinu.
As the Israelite people had stayed firm with Moses.
Kao što je izraelski narod čvrsto stao iza Mojsija.
And when Jesus comes back.
I kada se Isus bude vratio.
You and I will both cross the sea.
Vi i ja ćemo zajedno preći preko mora.
One more time.
Još jedan put.
And they will all be drowned.
A oni će se svi podaviti.
Yes.
Da.
Da. Da, srpski narod vrlo dobro zna kroz šta je prošao u proteklim vremenima.
Mi the Serbian people remember vividly their past history.
Srpski narod je 99. godine ovde doživeo bombardovanje najmoćnijih zemalja sveta osiromašenim uranijumom od koga i danas ostaju i u budućnosti će ostati posljedice.
The Serbian people in 1999 experienced a depleted uranium bombing with horrible after effects and people continue to die as a consequence of it.
Da. Tako da, ja mislim, ako vas neki narod razume u onome što vi govorite, to je svakako srpski narod.
So I would say if there is a nation capable of understanding your words, what you just said. That's the Serbian nation.
Da. Hajde da progovorimo. Hoćete nešto da prokomentarišete?
Do you want to comment? Mm-hmm. Go ahead.
The Serbian people remember their history.
Srpski narod se seća svoje istorije.
And I hope they will never forget it.
Ja se nadam da je nikada neće zaboraviti.
But very gently and humbly.
Ali sa puno smernosti.
I have come to the Balkans.
Ja sam došao na Balkan.
Or rather, the Lord God has sent me here.
Ili da se bolje izrazim, Gospod Bog me je poslao ovde.
To offer an Islamic eschatological explanation of part of that history.
Da ponudim islamsko eschatološko objašnjenje jednog dela te istorije.
What year was the Battle of Kosovo?
Koje godine je bila Kosovska bitka?
1389.
1389.
In 1389,
mm-hmm. 1389.
It was not Islam that you faced on the battlefield of Kosovo.
Vi se niste na bojnom polju na Kosovu suočavali sa Islamom.
In 1389, it was not Islam that defeated you on the battlefield of Kosovo.
1389. To nije bio Islam o koji vas je porazio u boju na Kosovu.
In 1389 you faced an enemy on the battlefield you could never have defeated.
1389. Vi ste se suočili sa neprijateljem na poprištu, na bojnom polju, koga ni u kom slučaju ne bi mogli da porazite.
No one could have defeated.
Niko ne bi mogao da ga porazi.
Islamic eschatology, which I am pioneering.
Islamska eschatologija koju ja učim.
And I speak these words with humility.
Ja sa najvećom smernošću izgovaram ove reči.
Recognizes the force that you faced on the battlefield of Kosovo.
Prepoznaje silu sa kojom ste se vi suočavali na bojnom polju na Kosovu.
To have been Gog and Magog.
Da je ta sila bila Gog i Magog.
You can continue now.
Možete nastaviti sada.
Da se nadovežem na ovo, ipak je mnogo našeg življa u vreme kosovskog boja i posle kosovskog boja prešlo u islam. Kako onda to objašnjavate?
Nevertheless, a lot of the local people embraced Islam after the Battle of Kosovo. How would you explain that?
The Antichrist is not a fool.
Antichrist nije budala.
He has a PhD in deception.
On ima doktorat iz varanja.
If he wants to come with 5% of poison.
Ako on dođe sa otrovom od 5%,
he will put it in a glass with 95% of truth.
On će taj otrov da stavi u čašu gde će 95% sadržaja biti istina.
And that's what's happening to this day.
I to se događa do dana današnjeg.
They pick up the glass and they drink it.
Oni podignu čašu i popiju je.
Seeing the 95% of truth.
Oni samo vide onih 95% istine.
And up to this day they still cannot see the 5% of poison.
I do dana današnjeg oni još uvek ne vide onih 5% što je otrov.
When they became Muslims in the Balkans.
Kada su primili islam na Balkanu.
Then Islam should have taught them.
Onda su trebali da prihvate i poruku
that they should have stood side by side with their Christian brothers,
da treba da stoje rame uz rame sa svojom hrišćanskom braćom,
to resist oppression,
da se odupru tlačitelju.
Instead they joined the oppressor.
Umesto toga oni su se pridružili tlačitelju.
And as a result of 600 years of foolishness on their part.
I kao posledica 600 godina gluposti sa njihove strane.
I have to now come to correct the record.
Ja sada moram da dođem da pokušam da to ispravim.
And they are angry with me.
I oni se ljute na mene.
But I don't care.
Ali mene baš briga.
for their criticisms.
Ne obraćam pažnju na njihovu kritiku.
Because if I have the truth,
jer ako ja imam istinu,
then the truth must prevail.
Onda istina mora da preovlada.
Da, to su te male, sitne nijanse, ali rekla bih neophodne u prepoznavanju istine o kojoj govorimo.
These are the small, almost imperceptible nuances, but they are indispensable in order to be able to recognize the truth.
I ono što mogu da dodam uz ovu priču jeste u sledećim rečima, a to je ja sam ipak veoma ponosna što pripadam srpskom narodu koji je bez obzira na sve posle nekoliko stoleća vladavine Otomanskog carstva ovde srušio to Otomansko carstvo.
I would just like to add, being Serbian, belonging to the Serbian nation, I'm actually quite proud that after 600 or so years, the nation that I belong to was successful in bringing down that Ottoman Empire.
Tako da Srbi su i u prošlosti, a nadam se i u ovim vremenima, pokazali ono čega se zapravo ne odriču, a to je neprestano uvažavanje prošlosti iz koje moramo učiti da bismo imali odgovornost prema budućnosti. I upravo smo došli na temu mog sledećeg pitanja koje
we have arrived now at my next question.
Koje je bilo i takođe nešto o čemu ste vi govorili na tribini pre neki dan.
Which goes back to something that you also talked about in your lecture the other day.
A to je nedavno, nedavni predlog gospodina Trumpa, predsednika Sjedinjenih Američkih Država, da Jerusalim proglasi za glavni grad države Izrael.
And that is the decision or the proposal of US President Trump to recognize Jerusalem as the capital of Israel.
Kako vi to vidite?
How do you see that?
I believe that most Americans who still have a capacity to think,
ja bih rekao da većina Amerikanaca koji još uvek imaju sposobnost da razmišljaju,
the American diplomatic service,
na primer američka diplomatska služba,
political scientists,
politički naučnici,
in the United States of America,
u Sjedinjenim Državama,
would recognize that American foreign policy under the control of Mr. Trump has now reached the garbage bin.
Oni će se verovatno složiti da američka spoljna politika pod pod direktivama gospodina Trumpa je završila na đubrištu.
And they must have reached a stage beyond frustration.
I ja mislim da su oni vrlo, vrlo uznemirani.
And most of them will agree with me now.
I da će se većina njih sada sa mnom složiti.
That what Trump has done is not just a big mistake.
Da je ono što je Trump učinio ne samo velika greška,
but a mistake which can never again be corrected.
Već da je to greška koja nikada više ne može biti ispravljena.
You have alienated the world of Orthodox Christianity.
Vi ste, odnosno oni su otuđili svet pravoslavnog hrišćanstva.
And you have alienated the world of Islam.
I otuđili su od sebe svet Islama.
And in the process you have made it inevitable.
I samim tim vi ste obezbedili
for the world of Islam and the world of Orthodox Christianity to come together in friendship and alliance.
Da će se svetovi pravoslavlja i islama neminovno udružiti.
And at a time when Russia is led by the most enlightened political leadership in the world today.
A Rusija je sada pod upravom najprosvećenijeg rukovodstva koje postoji u svetu danas.
At the time when Russia is led by a leadership with more credentials to moral credibility than any other leadership in the world today.
Nijedno drugo rukovodstvo u svetu ne uživa toliki moralni kredibilitet kao rusko.
One can now look forward with almost certainty that Russia will lead the way to a greater understanding and friendship between these two worlds successfully.
Sada možemo skoro sa skoro potpunim pouzdanjem da očekujemo da će Rusija povesti ta dva sveta na put uzajemnog razumevanja.
In the long term,
dalekosežno gledano,
what Trump has done,
ono što je Trump učinio,
is to put the last nail in the coffin,
je da je on zakucao posljednji ekser na kovčegu.
And now United States of America is riding into the sunset.
I Sjedinjene Američke Države sada polako idu u propast.
Zalaz. Da. Da, kad govorimo o tome, do nas dopiru neprestano neverovatne činjenice šta ISIS čini. Kažite, molim vas, kažite i ovde u Beogradu, kakva je to kreatura ISIS? Ko je to zapravo
izmislio? And talking about all that, we are getting all sorts of disturbing information about the things that the ISIS extremists are doing. So can you give us some idea of what kind of a creature is that? Where did they come from?
I have to choose my words carefully.
Moram pažljivo da biram reči.
And so I ask, who supplied them with all the state-of-the-art weapons?
Tako da bih prvo postavio pitanje, kojim je dostavio najmodernije oružje?
And who supplied them with a mountain of US dollars?
I kojim je dostavio brda američkih dolara.
And who facilitated their entry from so many different parts of the world into Syria and Iraq.
I kojim je napravio kanale iz raznih strana sveta da infiltriraju Siriju i Irak.
It is very plain and clear that Saudi Arabia played a very important role.
Jasno je da Saudijska Arabija u tome igrala vrlo važnu ulogu.
And that Qatar played an important role.
Da, Qatar također igrao vrlo važnu ulogu.
That Jordan played an important role.
Jordan je igrao važnu ulogu.
And that Turkey played an important role.
A također i Turska.
But we all know that these are client states.
Ali mi svi znamo da su to satelitske države.
So who is the mastermind who stands behind them?
Prema tome, ko je gazda koji stoji iza njih?
I think I prefer to use guarded language.
Ja više volim da se diskretnije izražavam.
It was Santa Claus who brought it.
to je bio Deda Mraz koji je sve to omogućio.
So these are ISIS is Santa Claus warriors.
ISIS, to su ratnici Deda Mraza.
But thanks to the much less courage and integrity of the leadership of Russia.
Ali zahvaljujući neospornom, neuporedivom moralnom integritetu i hrabrosti ruskog rukovodstva.
It was amazingly courageous of them.
I to je bilo neverovatno hrabro sa njihove strane.
To confront ISIS in Syria.
To što su radili da se u Siriji suprotstave ISIS-u.
Because the Russians knew that it was not just Saudi Arabia and Qatar and Turkey.
Jer Rusi su znali da to nije pitanje samo Saudijske Arabije, Jordana, Katara i Turske.
The Russians knew they were facing Santa Claus.
A Rusi su znali da se suočavaju sa Deda Mrazom.
And it could lead to nuclear war.
I da bi to moglo da rezultira nuklearnim ratom.
But the Russians intervened.
Ali Rusi su intervenisali.
And as a Muslim, I thank the Lord God that they did.
I kao musliman, ja se zahvaljujem Gospodu Bogu što su oni to učinili.
We have to be eternally grateful to the leadership of Russia.
I mi treba da budemo večno zahvalni ruskom rukovodstvu.
For had they not intervened, Syria would have become another Libya.
Jer da oni nisu intervenisali, Sirija bi postala druga Libija.
There are those who have eyes and yet cannot see.
Postoje oni koji imaju oči, ali ne vide.
They have the intellectual acumen of cattle.
Imaju pamet stoke.
And they cannot recognize what has happened to Libya.
I oni ne prepoznaju šta se dogodilo
and
sa Libijom.
So these cattle would not be able to recognize what would have happened to Syria if Russia had not intervened.
I zato ta goveda ne prepoznaju, ne shvataju šta bi se dogodilo sa Sirijom da je prošla kao Libija.
But cattle have a status less than a footnote on the pages of history.
Ali goveda, status goveda je nešto manje od fusnote na stranicama istorije.
So I say to the cattle, we don't care for your criticism.
A zato bih govedima poručio, mi ne obraćamo pažnju na vaš kritiku.
If Russia had not intervened, Syria would have been another Libya.
Da Rusija nije intervenisala, Sirija bi bila druga Libija.
If Russia had not intervened, ISIS would have been the government in Syria today.
Da Rusija nije intervenisala, ISIS bi bio vlada na vlasti u Siriji danas.
And the Syrian Christians would have been slaughtered.
A sirijski hrišćani bi bili poklani.
And a second Armenian genocide would have come to add to the first.
I dogodio bi se drugi jermenski genocid posle onog prvog.
To ensure that the words of Islam and Orthodox Christianity can never reconcile.
Da bi na taj način obezbedili da se svetovi pravoslavlja i islama nikada ne bi mogli pomiriti.
And if ISIS had formed a government in Syria,
i da je ISIS došla na vlast u Siriji,
Israel would have been smiling from this side to this side.
Izrael bi se smešio od uva do uva.
For Israel would have gotten causes bellum.
Jer Izrael bi na taj način dobio povod za rat.
To wage the big war that Israel wants to wage.
Da povede onaj veliki rat koji Izrael želi da otpočne.
And to be able to declare we are waging this war for a just cause.
I da bi mogli da kažu mi ovaj rat preduzimamo zato što je stvar za koju se borimo pravedna.
But they plan their plans.
Ali oni planiraju svoje planove.
And the Lord God planned his.
A Gospod Bog ima svoje planove.
And the Lord God sent Russia.
I Gospod Bog je poslao Rusiju.
To save Syria.
Da spase Siriju.
And praise is due to Lord God.
I treba da pohvalimo za to Gospoda Boga.
Da. Da. Da pohvalimo Gospoda Boga. Zbog tog plana, naravno, pridružujemo se tome, a takođe i ne obraćamo se onom delu, kako ste ih nazvali, govedima, jer ovo je emisija ne mainstreama, već jedne nezavisne televizije i mi pretpostavljamo da oni koji prate ove emisije vrlo dobro razumeju o čemu mi govorimo i koja je poruka ovih emisija.
Right, and we should bear in mind that our audience, since this is not a mainstream show, our audience really could not be classified as the cattle, as you refer to them. They are a bit better versed in world affairs and have more knowledge about the background of what is going on.
S tim u vezi volela bih da jedno od poslednjih pitanja, pošto nam vreme izmiče, a sa vama možemo da pričamo do ujutru.
Well, our time is running out, but we could go on talking to you until tomorrow
when
morning.
When I use the term cattle, yes. I was actually referring to those who instead of following Jesus were following Santa Claus.
Kada koristim reč goveda, ja sam mislio na one koji umesto da slede Isusa, slede Deda Mraza.
Mislili smo na istu stvar.
We were thinking of the same thing.
Volela bih da jedno od posljednjih eto pitanja bude
so one of my final questions will be
bude ovaj sljedeća knjiga koju pripremate i koja će se vjerovatno pojaviti i u Srbiji u izdanju izdavačke kuće Pešći sinovi osim ove knjige, a to je knjiga Antihrist koju ste najavili.
Tell us a little bit about the next book that you're planning, which perhaps our publishing house will have an opportunity to also publish in addition to this one. And as I understand it, that book is about the Antichrist.
I will answer you provided you promise me you will publish it.
Ja ću vam odgovoriti, ali ako vi obećate da ćete je objaviti.
Evo, pred svima obećam.
I promise that in front of our audience.
I left Malaysia.
Ja sam napustio Malaziju.
Where I have no time to write.
Gde nemam vremena za pisanje.
Too many visitors.
I suviše puno posetilaca.
Too many lectures.
I suviše predavanja.
Too busy.
Bio sam i suviše zauzet.
And I returned to my native Caribbean island of Trinidad.
I vratio sam se na moje rodno karibsko ostrvo Trinidad.
Where I have more time.
Gde imam više vremena.
I went back to write my book on Dajjal, the Antichrist.
Vratio sam se tamo da napišem moju sljedeću knjigu koja je posvećena Dajjalu, odnosno Antihristu.
I had been waiting to write this book for more than 10 years.
Više od 10 godina ja čekam priliku da napišem tu knjigu.
And I was frustrated that I could not get the time to write it.
I bilo mi je vrlo teško što nikako nisam mogao da pronađem vreme da to učinim.
I'm thankful to the Lord God that I'm able to do so now.
Ja sam zahvalan Gospodu Bogu što sada mogu to da uradim.
But as I sat down to write the book, I realized I could not write one book.
Ali kada sam seo i počeo da pišem, postalo mi je jasno da ne mogu to da uradim u samo jednoj knjizi.
The Antichrist is too comprehensive and too complex a subject.
Antihrist je i suviše sveobuhvatna i složena tema.
I realized that I had to write several books.
Postalo mi je jasno da moram da napišem nekoliko knjiga.
But I am 75 years of age.
Ali ja imam 75 godina.
And I'm tired now.
I umoran sam.
So I sat down and decided to write 5.
I ja sam seo i odlučio sam da napišem 5 knjiga.
And the other books will have to be written by others.
A preostale knjige na tu temu će morati da napišu drugi.
I have completed the first book, praise be to God.
Hvala Bogu, završio sam prvu knjigu.
It is on the Antichrist and the beginning of history.
A to je o Antihristu i početku istorije.
And there will be the Antichrist and the end of history as well.
A također u toj seriji će biti i Antihrist i kraj istorije.
There will be a book of the Antichrist and money.
Biće knjiga o Antihristu i finansijskom sistemu.
Which is a very, very, very important subject.
A to je vrlo, vrlo, vrlo važna tema.
There will be a book on the Antichrist and the feminist revolution.
Biće knjiga o Antihristu i feminističkoj revoluciji.
But the crown jewel of all 5 books.
Ali krunski dragulj te serije od 5 knjiga.
Will be a book entitled.
Će biti knjiga koja će se zvati.
From Jesus, the true Messiah.
Od Isusa, istinitog Mesije.
To Dajjal, the false Messiah.
Do Dajjala, lažnog Mesije.
A journey in Islamic eschatology.
A put kroz islamsku eschatologiju, pod naslov.
I hope you will publish all 5.
Ja se nadam da ćete vi objaviti svih 5.
Dragi šejh Imran Hosein.
Dear Sheikh Imran Hussein.
Sa velikim zadovoljstvom izdavačka kuća Pešći sinovi bit će vaš ekskluzivni izdavač na ovim prostorima.
With great pleasure, the publisher Pešić and Sons will be your publisher in this region.
Thank you.
Hvala.
I kao što je ova prva knjiga u izdanju kuće Pešći sinovi, knjiga koja, za koju sam sigurna da će ostaviti trag na bilo kog čoveka.
And just as I'm sure that this first book, the introduction to the methodology of studying the Quran will leave a deep impression on every reader who touches it.
Bez obzira kojoj on religiji pripada.
Regardless of religion.
Jer svi smo mi konačno deca jednoga Boga.
Because in the end we are all children of the one God.
Tako sam sigurna i da će vaše sledeće knjige takođe biti veoma brzo objavljene u našoj kući i da ćete nas iz tog razloga vrlo skoro ponovo posetiti.
I am just sure that the books that are to come, that you're preparing to write, will also be published by us and that we will have the pleasure and the honor of seeing you here again.
Thank you very much.
Hvala vam puno.
Hvala vama na ovom razgovoru.
Thank you for this conversation.
A vama, dragi gledaoci, eto da poželim da se vidimo ponovo i sledeće subote. Moj gost danas je bio šejh Imran Azhar Hosein, jedan od najboljih poznavalaca islamske eskatologije danas u svetu. Moje ime je Vesna Pešić i pošto svako ima Vesnu Pešić kakvu zaslužuje, vi ste eto zaslužili ovu emisiju. Doviđenja do sledeće subote.